Verily, verily, I say unto you, that the kingdom of heaven is like unto a businessman who receiveth a franchise for the local supermarket, which, when he hath filled it with all manner of produce for the good of humanity, doth advertise for customers to come and buy. And lo, while his employees slept, a salesman for a rival chain cometh and placeth his brand of merchandise upon the shelves, making sure that his prices are less than those of the company's brand. When the employees of the supermarket discovered the false merchandise, they sought out the manager and findeth him at the front doors, ready to unlock them for the first customers. Good sir, the employees said unto him, an enemy salesman has come into the store in the night and placed his merchandise upon your shelves. Behold, it is everywhere, and much lower priced than our brand. Shall we therefore keep the store closed while we seek to remove the enemy's brand? Then spake the good manager unto his employees, saying, nay, not so, for lift up thine eyes and behold, the customers are already waiting to enter. The time is at hand. I must open the doors. Leave the merchandise on the shelves, and let the customers choose, for perchance they may be able to distinguish between the good and the evil. But, good manager, remonstrated the clerks, what if they cannot? Then spake the good manager, fear not, for it shall be that when they come to the cash register, you shall point out their mistake and exchange the false merchandise for the true. And so it was that the clerks obeyed the good manager. They took their places at the checkout counter, and the doors were opened. The customers entered to make their selections.
Expensive. I've seen anywhere. I never knew then I might need some. My husband is always coming up with something to upset me.
Look at this bargain. Every sin, they're giving away a package of guilt. I can't believe it. They practically, they're giving all away.
Frustration.
After what happened to me this week, doubt is just what I need.
Wow, criticism is at 80% discount, and I have received plenty this week. But you know, I'm gonna get back even.
Pessimism, my favorite day to start the day. I'll buy 2 boxes to make it sure that I'm not run out.
But are you sure doubt is all you want?
Of course. Do you know what happened to me this week? I lost my job. It's not fair, I tell you. God could have done something about it, but he didn't. I'm beginning to wonder if he even exists. I'm beginning to wonder if he really cares. Getting a job is not easy. I've prayed and nothing has happened. Sometimes wonder if he even exists. Yes, doubt is just what I feel like doing.
Trust really works better. It's hard for us to understand why bad things happen to us, but trust believes that all things work together for good to those who love God. He's promised to never leave or forsake those who trust in him. Won't you give it a try?
Thank you. I think I will.
Forgiveness works wonders. I try it if I were you. I know that it's hard to believe, but I've seen whole families change with the use of forgiveness. Maybe. There's enough here to make at least 490 applications.
Really? 490? That's 70 times 7. Seems I remember Jesus saying something about forgiving that many times. Okay, I'll take it.
If it hasn't worked for 490 applications, come back and I'll give you this for free.
Oh, I have such a hard life. Nobody can suffer the thing that I have endured. And I can't begin to tell you how much I need this self-pity. I really need this.
I tell you this, self-pity only makes you feel worse. It's addicting too. The more you use it, the more you want it. Be honest! Look around you. There are so much people with lots of problems, more than you.
What you need is a dose of sharing. When you try to help others by sharing their burden, it makes your own heart lighter, honestly.
Here, I'll give you sharing. I pick up some fresh fruit from my garden, oranges and tangerines. And I bake bread. And over here, I have also green beans to give to your neighbors or to your friends.
You got a point. Okay, I'll try this. You know, this year I have my garden too, and I have the green beans too, and these frogs too, like yours. I think I'm gonna share this to my neighbor who has an accident this year. We don't even know.
Thank the beach the world this year.
I share.
Oh, I feel so depressed. Nothing even turns out right. I'm a loser. Guess what I am? There's nothing. Nothing helpful.
Oh, but there is. You don't need to take home depression.
It's okay. I used it.
Why don't you give Smiles and a Song a try? This brand will really make you feel a lot better.
But I don't feel like smiling and singing. I feel like being depressed.
But Smiles, Smiles and a Song really has a secret ingredient to make you feel happier. Come on, try it and smile for me.
Smiling? You know what? I don't feel better. I go with a smile and a song for this.
Smile and a song is a good choice for everyone, so let's try it. You certainly want a lot of criticism.
You got it wrong. I don't want criticism. I want to give it back to all those who have criticized me. I'm ready to get even.
And then they'll return the criticism, so what progress have you made? Wouldn't you rather make friends and enemies?
You know, if they wanted to be my friends, they wouldn't have criticized me in the first place.
Our appreciation brand. It has a way of wiping out criticism. It actually turns enemies into friends.
Amen.
You don't say. That sounds terrific. But how do you give it on people who have so many faults?
Everybody has some redeeming feature. Look for the good in everyone and appreciate that. Ignore what you don't like. Praise what you do like. You'll find the good growing and the bad shrinking. Appreciation actually gets rid of faults.
Good. Give me lots of appreciation. I have a lot of people to give it to.
I think all of us need to practice the brand appreciation. It's a team too, the appreciation brand. For me, I have three persons here that I really, really like to thank for the appreciation. One is my Auntie Debbie, for when I came here 25 years ago, he sewed my wedding dress. To sew a wedding dress is not a cheap one. So it costs you so much money, they call that labor of love. And I would like to thank also Dale, and another one is May. Me and everybody should have the appreciation brand. Surely you don't want to carry that heavy box of guilt?
But Lord, this is free. I'm not the person who passes up something free. Even if it's heavy, I can handle it.
Oh, but you didn't read that fine print? Yeah. Is it really free? You pay in sickness, pain, headache, heartache, and sorrow. If you hang it on long enough, you pay with your life. For the wages of sin is death.
Oh, that is not a good deal at all.
Try grace instead. God's grace will forgive all your sins the moment you confess them. God's grace will bury your sins in the depths of the sea, and you'll remember them no more. God's grace will bring you joy, peace, and eternal life.
Oh, grace is all I need.
Grace.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't want all this frustration either. I read the fine print, and it caused an ulcer and high blood pressure.
You're right. We have something much better. It's called quiet time. To use this, you need to spend time with God alone every day, reading His Word, praying and thinking about Him. Taking a walk in nature also helps. Our frustration vanishes as we spend time with God.
Amen.
exactly what I need. I need some quiet time.
Do you always start your day with pessimism?
Oh, yes. How else? We start the day. The world is so such a mess. There's trouble in the Middle East, trouble in the Philippines, trouble in the politics, and even the White House, and there's also trouble in the church. I used to think that the Lord is coming soon, but now I don't see how he can. Because we aren't doing what we should be doing.
What you need is hope. You need to cheer up and look on the bright side. There are lots of good things going on to happen this world. The Lord is still in control.
Amen. Like where?
Where? He's at work. The church is growing and prospering.
You know the Lord is at work. With him in control, there's a hope.
Amen.
And it shall come to pass that at closing time, the good manager will remove the false merchandise from the supermarket shelves and throw it into the trash container. Then the garbage truck will come and take it all away so that these things will never again tempt the customers. Bad merchandise shall not fill the shelves a second time. Until that day, I say unto you, watch and pray that ye buy not the wrong merchandise. Amen.
Markets are filled with different kinds of produce. We hope bad merchandise shall not fill the shelves a second time. Until the day I say unto you, watch and pray that we buy not the wrong merchandise. If we pay attention to God's teaching, we will become stronger people in a moment of crisis. The Father say, dear children, why like this? Have I not told you? Trust my love. It's the vision that I care for you each day. Living our life filled with negative feelings is going to make us suffer. The only solution is God's word. We need to cultivate a calm trust in God, connect with heaven, and cling to Jesus. Days are filled with sorrow and care. Hearts are lonely and weary. Burdens are lifted at Calvary. Jesus is very near. So let's all stand for our closing song. It's found in 476. Burdens are lifted.
Thank you. heads for the benediction. Kind and gracious Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this Sabbath day and this opportunity to gather together to praise your holy name. Lord, we pray that we will not be the tares, the weeds. We pray that we will make the right decisions to choose not the bad gifts, but the good things that you offer for us in life. We have your true, abundant, and full life that you have promised to us. Be with us now as we go on our Sabbath day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.